Good morning, John Tisbury here, and in this video I'm going to take you through our solar stats for June 2019, and it hasn't been too good. If you're interested in solar PV, Tesla Powerwall, that kind of thing, working with models, cinematography, photography, then click the subscribe button and hit that notification bell icon to be notified of new updates as and when I upload them. In this video, as I said earlier, I'm going to concentrate on our PV figures for June 2019. And it hasn't been a particularly good month, in fairness. I've done much better in April and May. But hey-ho, still worth recording and still made some benefits from having the solar and the Powerwall. Anyway, without further ado, let's get on with it. Hi. So let's get to it and work our way through the stats for June 2019. If you've not been with us before, let's give you a little bit of background so you can understand the stats and how they work if you're comparing against your own setup. So I know a lot of people do that. We're in the UK. We're based in the East Midlands. We have a 4 kilowatt PV solar array, and connected to that is a 3.8 inverter, a Sunny Boy inverter. We also have a Powerwall 2. And we charge our Powerwall purely from excess solar at the moment. So we're not on any dual rate where we can pump cheap electricity at a low rate during the evening. That will change in July, but at the moment we're not quite there. In fact, quite a lot of changes happening in sort of July stroke August. In terms of, in July we've had the Kona EV, we picked that up, and we're also looking to install more solar. An Eddie from My Energy, a Harvey from My Energy, seem to be a My Energy sponsor here. And we've also got the Hub, I've just installed that, and we've got the Zappy as well from previous, and it's been used in earnest now from the 1st of July. We'll cover all of that in another video. So in this video, I'm going to walk you through my normal spreadsheet. If you're interested in the facts and figures and looking at the spreadsheet in more detail, I'll put a link to it down below so you can pick it up from the description. I'll drop it into a Dropbox for you. So I know some people like to compare and have a look in a little bit more detail about the stats. And without further ado, let's nip on. It's like ant killer, isn't it? Something like that. Yeah. A couple of new tabs as well, a couple of new charts to mooch through. So we shall talk about those as we go. The first one we look at is the monthly solar generation, the PV generation. And we run that as a total and also a daily average. For June, we had a total of 441 kilowatt hours, which was down on May and down on April, actually. And only just beat March. So May was not a great month here for, in a particular area, for solar power generation. We had lots of cloud. We had lots of rain, like biblical rain. Very strange conditions. It was more like April in June, sort of like April showers, that type of thing. It was dark, moody, black, thunderstorms, you name it. We had it. And that had an impact on our solar generation. So that's why that's so low. For instance, if you compare that to May, as you see there, it's 533 kilowatts in May, as opposed to 441. So almost 100 kilowatts less, 90 odd, over the course of the month, which impacted our average daily. And that ran out at 14.7 kilowatt hours of solar generated. Compare that to May, which was 17.2. So sort of 3 kilowatts a day less on average, which tops up over the course of the month to quite a big significant figure that we don't get. So hey-ho. And if we scroll down, have a look at the next one, which is the percentage contribution to self-power of our Powerwall and our solar. In June, solar contributed 47% of the total self-power, and Tesla did the same actually as it did in May. So 38% of our self-power was generated by the Powerwall. Overall, that brought us to 85% self-power for the month, which was actually pretty good compared to the fact that it was so poor in terms of our solar generation. So I'm fairly happy with that. No, in fact, I'm very happy with that. And as I said, because we don't pump any additional power into the Powerwall from the grid, it is all excess solar. So it does rely on solar generation to help with our self-power consumption, or total, not consumption. If we compare that against May we were at 90%, and so you know, quite a significant difference, but only 5% overall, so quite interesting. Let's have a look at a new chart. This is the efficiency of the Tesla Powerwall. So I've recorded each month and gone back historically to December when it was installed, what went in and what came out each month as a total, and worked out the efficiency of those two figures. In June, we pumped in from the sun 208 kilowatts into the Powerwall and pulled 178 kilowatts. There's always going to be some cutoff at the beginning of the month or the end of the month. So I'll do a rolling average over the course of sort of 3 months or 6 months. So I'm not too worried about the fact that on the 1st of June it may have been full or empty, and likewise at the end of the month, because it'll even itself out over the course of the averaging. What that has meant, that in terms of the efficiency of the Powerwall, it was running at 86% efficiency. So we got 80%, 86% of the power back out from what we pumped into it, which is about normal, looking at other people's efficiency ratings. We've sort of moved around between 87% to 85%, so it's sort of fluctuating around those two values. So that's a new one. What else have we got? Oh, another new one. This is a day-by-day for the month of June 2019, and I've mapped in their total house usage, that's showing in blue, the solar generation showing in green, probably be in yellow really, but anyway, it's in green, and then what we've exported to the grid is showing in red. And you can see there that by and large house usage in most days outstripped solar generation, with the few exceptions. And then when those green peaks are above the blue, you'll see there's also a little red bar to it, because we've generally exported to the grid. That will now change quite significantly with the Kona Electric being plugged into the Zappy and making benefit, or taking benefit, of any excess solar that we don't use during the day. It'll go into charge the car, so we should see that grid change hopefully. Another tab is the Kona tab, charging, so we'll leave that for this month, look at it next month. Something new for you as well. This chart, which you'll be familiar with if you've tuned in before, is our monthly average home use and average grid use in kilowatt hours. So in June, we averaged 14.2 on a daily basis. That's basically what the house used. Whereas in May, we were 14.4, so a 200 watt saving in June. And in terms of what we actually pulled from the grid that month, we did 2.6 kilowatts on average each day from the grid, and in May it was 2.8. So again, a bit of a saving, so like for like saving really of 200 watts. This particular chart looks at our monthly grid usage. So in terms of what was sent to the grid and what was pulled from the grid, the top one is what we sent to the grid. In June, we sent 66 kilowatts, or 66.6 to be accurate. And comparing that to May, which was the bumper month, we sent 154 kilowatts to the grid. So a major cut there, but that's really down to the fact that there was less sun rather than any other efficiencies in the system or the setup. Again, that will change as we put in the the eddy and the to heat the hot water, and use the EV more by charging that. The chart below is what we pulled from the grid, and total for that month of June is 77 kilowatts as opposed to 86 in May. So again, that's tracking downwards. And yeah, that's all the stats I wanted to go through. So a quick update for June 2019 on our system. Any questions, then drop them down below in the comments. There are other videos if you're interested on our PV installation and solar installation. So do click on those, and obviously hit that subscribe button, hit the notification bell icon to be notified of new updates as and when I do them. All right. Okay. Thanks for watching. See you again. Take care. Bye.